Ford in at the point. For the 76ers, we've got McKee. He's out there with Allen Iverson. Big Dog is out there with Iguodala. And it's Mashburn in at the power forward. Now, here is Ford. Out to Smith. Right wing. Second shot opportunity. Head against McKee. Pocket six. The pass to four. Takes it inside. And it's sent back from Talonbear.
Yeah, trying to get going here, but that's an offer for the first five here to start the game.
Offensive rebound.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be because he is so strong in the paint.
Doubled by Iverson. Here's Smith. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact. And he'll go to the line for two. They get Andre Iguodala.
Yeah, good job to take him right at the line.
The Bucks shooting their first free throws of the night right here. The free throw drops for Smith. For teams with a lot of new players, Greg, this time of year can be a real challenge.
Sure can. And just getting on the same page takes some time. And then you have to build that trust. Weathering the storms together will help you do that.
Smith hits them both. And so it's Iguodala. He'll bring it up for the 76ers. They're getting their first look of the season at the Bucks in this one.
And they're hoping for a better showing against this club this season. Last year they came out on the losing end.
Here's Ford. Goes back up. That one's not going to go. Iverson with some nice D.
It's almost as if there's a lid on the hoop for him right now. Still hasn't gotten to the ball. You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
How about them not settling? I mean, instead of being lazy with the shot selection, they go right to the rim.
Ford passes to Smith. Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. They shoot again, and it's sent back from Talonbear. Here's Booth. Missed it, even after all those chances. Talonbear dishes to Iverson. And Talonbear with the slam.
Oh, great flow to that possession. Two players totally in sync with each other.
Here is Ford. And looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. And he drops in the layup off the glass.
Oh, that's a well-deserved assist. Not every player has the vision to make that feat.
Here's Iguodala. Kukoc with the defensive effort.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Four. Doesn't go for him.
Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Off this quarter. You know he's going to keep working to try to turn it around.
Yeah, and Mashburn, really one of the more versatile guys at that forward position. He can score, rebound, and pass all at a high level.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. First one falls for him. He's perfect from the line this time.
And what an advantage. You really feel like you can always trust him when he's at the line.
Pass to Red. And here's Kukoc. To the paint, here's Smith. He's just scored his first basket with that shot, making him 1-for-4.
Yeah, and what you love about Kukoc is the versatility on offense and the terrific court vision.
Talonbear can't hit that one. Now the Bucks take it the other way.
Well, you look at the points they produced in that game. Great adjustments on the offensive end.
In-game adjustments are critical. They did an awesome job taking what the defense gave.
Ford against Iverson, and Iverson throws it down.
And Iverson constantly driving to the basket, using that speed and athleticism to kind of wheel his way to the rim.
Passes it to Smith. Inside. A good finish at the rack off the slick feet. Smith's got six.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter
on the inside. That's size winning out. I mean, he needed every single inch to haul in that one.
And for three, it's hauled in by Allen Iverson.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
It's deflected. And for three, rebounded by McKee.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
And it's good. 2 points. 8 points for him.
They tailored their offense around him. And let me tell you, he loves playing in the system.
And it's Allen Iverson with the foul.
Allen Iverson.
That's his first foul.
Second team foul.
Milwaukee trails by four. Now, here is Red. Coming off a stellar performance against Washington.
Aaron McKee, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
First trip to the line for him here.
And all you need to do is see his free throw percentage, guys. 94 this season to know what kind of year he's had.
Philadelphia with the ball.
And it was one of those games where it was just hard to get anything going. And you could see frustration emerge.
It's hard not to get discouraged on such an off night shooting the ball, but somehow they kept the intensity up. I mean, that was a really gutty win.
Here's Iverson. Here's D'Alembert.
He just can't find the touch this quarter. He's got to keep grinding, though, and looking for the best shot possible.
Down low. And it's all evened up.
Oh, good interior offense. Those passes have to be right on target.
Iverson against four. D'Alembert. No good that time.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look. I mean, he's been taking some bad shots.
Here's Ford. Here's Booth. No luck that time on the shot that would have put them on top.
Team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy, and theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
The assist is the key to that sequence. I mean, a great look to set them up.
Now, here is Smith. 6 points for him. Kukoc passes to Smith. And it's rebounded by Mashburn. Philadelphia shooting just about an even 40% to start. The drive by Iverson. And it's blocked. To the inside. And stolen by D'Alembert. Iverson against Kukoc. And Iverson throws it down.
And not just that, it's the energy and passion with which Iverson plays. It just feels like any shot he takes, he can make.
Doesn't have to break stride at all, thanks to the money lead pass.
Iverson against Ford. Here's D'Alembert. Good. And it's Iverson who picks up the assist. D'Alembert's got his second bucket of the night.
And they've repeatedly poked inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
And Milwaukee calls their first timeout of the game.
Trying to find some answers offensively. Milwaukee.
Bad shot selections. Well, it's some bad luck. I mean, that's not going to help you score points.
Catching up on the changes for Philadelphia. Jackson, he's checked in for Big Dog. And the machine subbed in for McKee. Now here's Williams. He picked up 12 points in their last win against Washington.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
Iverson gets to Corbin. He dishes it to Jackson. And it's blocked. Here is Williams. He gives the team some steady offense, a bit under 10 points a game. And there's the drive. Second chance shot. Gansa Reach gets the bucket. And this game is tied up now.
Man, he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Iverson dishes to Jackson. Kicks it out to Iverson. From deep three-point range. Mashburn, no good. The Bucks shooting only 28% here in the first. A shoddy game offensively for them so far. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. And let's now take a look at some of the numbers for him.
And the stat to look at is his steal total over the last five games. He's been focusing more on his defense, trying to be a disruptor, and it's made them a lot tougher on D.
they now lead as the free throw drops for him. The Bucks making a change here. Hills check in, and that one goes in. Two from the line that time. Philadelphia shooting just about an even 40% to start. Iverson passes to Mashburn. Here's Jackson, and the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
There's that passion of his, battling with every ounce of energy he has.
Pass to Strickland. He kicks it to Williams. And he drives in, down to five on the shot clock. Here's Gonsarić. The kick out to Williams. Over Mashburn. Offensive rebound. Gonsarić misses. Iverson against Pachulia. It's tipped, and it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Williams.
Great instincts from him to get a hand on that pass and tip it out.
We're just trying to prevent the opposition from getting comfortable. Next time, that one might get picked.
A tremendous Mobile One block that we had to see again. Great send back.
And that is a huge block. Given how close this game is, a stop like that was right on point.
Now here's Korver. He's still scoreless so far in this one. And Pachulia pulls it down. And so it's Williams who brings it up for Milwaukee.
76ers foul. First personal foul. Fifth team foul.
For Milwaukee, they have made all of their free throws so far tonight, going 6 for 6.
Two shots.
Falls for Williams. Hamilton's checked in for Milwaukee. And Williams drops them both. Iverson with the ball. Last time out, he had 44 points. To the middle. Here's Jackson. It's good. Jackson's got the game tied up here for Philadelphia.
Look, the D will give it to you. That's where you want your shots coming from. Arms length from the bucket.
Williams attacking. Here's Gonsarić. To the right side. Strickland. No good on the triple. The 76ers shooting 42% to begin this game. Trying for the go-ahead basket. It doesn't go in. The Bucks shooting pretty grave so far, about 23%. Hill, the pass to Strickland. Here's Hamilton. To the wing right side. Six to shoot. Gets a reach. Great positioning
timeout,
on the putback. He's got six.
Smooth. Guys, very good job getting himself in close enough that he could just tip it back in.
Well said. Those kind of plays in the offensive glass can tell the story sometimes, can't they? And Philadelphia decides to take their first timeout right here. And the 76ers with possession. Trailing by two. Down low. Here's Bradley. An easy 2 points on the layup.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Williams passes to Gill. Back to Williams. Ollie grabs the board.
He struggles with his finishes sometimes. I mean, it's kept him from being an elite player.
Here's Barnes, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. For Philadelphia, they have had two chances at the line already, making a both.
At the line for two.
Now the free throw is good, now leading by one. The Erasers checked in for the Bucks. James comes in for Williams. hits them both. There's a minute 47 left in the first quarter. Holly against James. Now the pass to Strickland. Fires the three. The shot that time, not on target. Now the 76ers take it the other way. Outside for Korver. The three. No good on the shot. Fast break, Milwaukee. Gill, the pass to the eraser. Here's James. Second chance effort. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. The Bucks have been a perfect 8 of 8 at the line.
And they shot the ball well this season in terms of their attempts. 81%.
And he sinks the second. 76ers shooting the ball to the tune of 41% from the field so far.
And he just bangs down the one hand.
Two very easy points right here. Selmans grabs the miss.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense did give up on that play and cut him off. That is ferocious.
You said it. That was ferocious. Now here's James. 9-point game, his last outing. Pass to the eraser. No good there. Korver with the defensive effort. 7-second difference, shot and game clock. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Here's Holly. He takes it in. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him. Now it's a 7-point 76ers lead. Passes it to the eraser. Gill against Korver. Here's Gill. Shoots over Korver. And so it's Philadelphia. Heading to the bench with a 7-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. We'll return shortly. And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And looking at what we've seen from the 76ers, what do you guys think?
What we saw in that first quarter, they won their matchups defensively.
Yeah, they really got after it. I mean, they made life extremely difficult for the shooters, which is why they hold this lead.
And Philadelphia has possession. They'll be playing host to Toronto for the next one. That'll be the last of three straight at home for the team. They've got Matt Barnes. Big Danny is out there with Ali. Then there's Bradley, and it's Brown in at the three, the small forward. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. Now here's James. Here's Gill. Here he goes. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, G.A., right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
They needed that, and I love that he just didn't settle for the lay-in.
Bradley can't get it to go. Milwaukee trails by five. Strickland passes to James. Pass to Gill. Six on the shot clock. Dishes to Hamilton. From 17 feet out. And it's Strickland missing.
Oh, you hate to let those easy chances slip through the fingers.
Here's Holly. And for Milwaukee, they're shooting a rough 22% so far in this one. Here's Fizer, and he jams it with authority.
Good to see a player going all out when the game's this tight.
You know, G.A., he knows what his job is. Control the offensive glass.
Second chance opportunity so big in this instance. You know, they have to feel fortunate that they can extend that foul.
And it's Captain Clutch with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Green's checked in for the 76ers. McKee comes in for Allen. closing in on 2 minutes played here in the second quarter. James kicks to four. Driving inside. Gets one to drop finally after missing on his first 8 attempts.
I like that big play. I mean, you can see how easily it makes it for him to get to the cup.
And it's Green missing. The Bucks have gone 3 of their first 5 shots to drop here in the second quarter. Smith on the wing. Goes up the baseline. That shot, no good. Now the 76ers take it the other way. To the inside. And stolen by James. Smith finishing it off.
And the second chance becomes a dunk. We could feel over here.
Yeah, GA, such a good, aggressive play in the paint. And the 76ers call time here. There might be more talent at the point guard position now, Greg, than there's ever been in the NBA. But who do you think sits at the top of that list?
I mean, Kevin, there's so many incredible talents. And not that I'm dodging it, but honestly, the beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Depends on what kind of tickles your fancy in terms of the point guard. If it's the ability to shoot and play without it, Steph's at the top of your league list. But then you get a guy like Chris Paul, who I think is as good as anybody's ever been in the pick and roll. So they're just different ways to approach this thing. And of course, now I've forgotten 4 or 5 guys that I should have added into this conversation.
Now, here's Brown. Connects from 3-point range. Barnes has got 5 now. We've seen the lead change hands quite a bit in this one.
And guys, I think each team knows they can win this game. Just a matter who can catch that momentum.
Kukoc from outside. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. McKee's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. And Michael Redd gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul.
First team foul.
And in the second quarter, a little under 3.5 minutes played already. The kick out to Barnes. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Puts up a 3. McKee, no luck. The Bucks shooting 36% in the second quarter. They really haven't found their rhythm yet offensively here. Here's Ford. Barnes grabs the miss. And it's Barnes with the ball for the 76ers. Brown finds Barnes. Back to Brown. Shot from 12. A rebound by the Bucks.
You know what? Those are shots you just hate to miss when you get those kinds of bunnies on a possession.
Red. And he stays with it.
Yeah, just nice hustle there. That work gets them the extra possession.
Here's Ford. And it's sent back from Dallenberg. Brown dishes to Dallenberg. Tries again. He'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing. And there's the foul against Milwaukee. The 76ers have hit all 4 of their chances so far in this one.
And 75% on the season as a unit from the free throw line.
And the Bucks making a change here. Milwaukee trails by 4. Williams passes to Smith. Now here is Red. Again, the Bucks miss.
His offense has been non-existent tonight. It's really hurt.
And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. Philadelphia shooting their 7th and 8th attempts at the foul line tonight. The first one falls.
No wasted trips at all. They're taking care of business at the line.
And the Bucks making a change here. Hatzerich is checked in. The Bucks shooting a rough 22% so far in this one. Here's Williams, going inside, scores for only the 2nd time tonight. Now 2 for 6 from the field. The 76ers leading by 4, deflects the pass. Nice shot by Dallenberg. Dallenberg has got 4 this quarter.
Oh, forget about 3-pointers. Give me a look from right in tight. I'll take it all day long.
Kukoc pass to Red. On the wing, Williams. Inside, on the wing, Kukoc. Just 5 to shoot. Shoots over Brown. coach. Can't get it to go.
Setup's good. That's the shot they're looking for, but you can't get them all to go.
Here's Barnes. Rebounded by the Bucks. And that game will be game 3 of 5 away from home. It's Williams with the drive, and it's sent back from Tallenberg.
You know what kind of competitor he is? I know he's upset with his performance and the score. Great teamwork, punctuated by a strong finish. Perfect example of how to run the break the right way and get a great look.
Now here's Williams. 6 points for him. The pass to Red. Shoots the three. The offensive rebound. Gets a reach, gets the
timeout,
bucket.
Timeout.
Toughness and energy on the boards. An easy putback to show for.
And the 76ers call time here. And it's a completely new group here for Philadelphia. The 76ers leading by 6. Now Iverson, 12 points for him. Jackson kicks to Iguodala. Over Kukoc. And the shot falls short this time.
For a player who's almost a sure thing to score in tight, that was a stunner.
Another shot. The kick out to Williams. Back to Kukoc. And finally they hit one. Kukoc has got his first bucket of the night.
And how about the perseverance offensively? I mean, following up the missed shot, and that results in second and third opportunities.
Here's Jackson. Excellent D there from Pachulia. Milwaukee trails by 4. Pass to Red. Back to Williams. Gets a reach, kicks to Kukoc. It's Red outside. Allen Iverson grabs the miss. Iverson's got 4 rebounds in this game. Mashburn, and he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
The feed just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
The coaching staff has to be upset. You can't give the opposition easy baskets like this.
They get the rebound. Here is Gansarich, guarded by Korver, scooped up. Gets a reach, gets the bucket.
It's been their Achilles heel defensively. They just have not been able to control that backboard.
The drive by Iverson. Jackson, out of hand on it. Outside Williams, into the lane. That's tipped. Now the 76ers on the break. Holds it up for Iguodala. Up high to stuff the alley-oop.
Still showing prime time explosiveness at the rim. Nice catch and drop by Iguodala.
Iverson against Williams.
76ers foul.
Gill is checked in for Tony Kukoc.
Personal foul. Second team foul. Substitution for Milwaukee. Kendall Gill.
Williams looking over the floor. Passes it to Gill. Shot clock at 6. Red for 3. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Ashburn's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
And he's really trying to get them back into it, but the results just have not been there.
Now here's Iverson. 12 points for him. And Pachulia pulls it down. Pachulia's got rebound number 5 here tonight. And for 3, rebounded by Jackson.
His bad night from the field is only going to get worse if he keeps throwing up shots like that.
Outside Williams. And he uses the glass on the lane. Williams has got his 3rd bucket of the night. Philadelphia leading by 4. To the paint. Here's Mashburn. That's good. Great play set up by Iverson. Iverson's got assist number 5 here tonight.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Gill against Iguodala. Gill, the pass to Gansarich. It's stolen by Korver. He lobs it up, trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense in anticipation there to stop it. He He can't get that one to fall. And the 76ers go the other way with it. Iverson with the ball. Williams picks him up.
Snatched up.
Here's Jackson. And at last, they get one to fall. Jackson's got the lead up to 8 now for the 76ers. Gill, the pass to Pachulia. Broke loose. Iverson outside. And here's Iguodala outside. Milwaukee with the rebound. And here is Red. He's scoring an average of 33 points a game, a stunning total for a truly remarkable player. Fires from 18. Rebounded by Jackson. Jackson's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Iguodala outside. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark.
Really tough night for him offensively. I mean, I wonder what the score would be if he wasn't so cold from the field.
Here's Williams. And the layup is good. Williams has got 10 points in the game.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
And there's the feed to Jackson. Second chance effort. Misses from close range.
Well, in the rebounding game, at least, it's been a strong physical performance for him.
Williams attacking. Great D that time from Iguodala. And so it's Iguodala. He'll bring it up for the 76ers. 6-point lead. Korver, good.
I mean, he makes plays like that in his sleep. The game is just far too easy.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need a basket.
Williams kicks to Pachulia. Baseline Jay on the way. They get it back. Gantzer reach misses. Now here's Iguodala. Good if it goes. And that shot was up in time, but doesn't go in. Here's Iverson. They lead by 8. That's the biggest of the game. Our second half of basketball. And presented by Gatorade. The team's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. On the court for the Bucks. Two coaches out there with Smith. And it's Michael Redd. And it's Ford in at the 1. So it's the Bucks now. Philadelphia getting their last shot to go. Here's Ford. The shot misses. The 76ers go the other way with it. The try by Iverson. Here's Mashburn. It's hauled in by Michael Redd. Milwaukee trails by 10. Pass to Ford. Outside, Kukoc. Right against McKee. Shot clock at 5. Fires the 3. Rebounded by McKee. The 76ers leading by 10. The try by Iverson. And the dunk by Iverson.
Just rubbing it in their faces with that dunk.
He is never going to take his foot off the pedal.
What a performer this guy is. He relishes the chance to have every time.
And with a little over a minute gone, the second half is underway. Ford passes to Smith. Over Iverson. And it's Smith missing.
This is not the start they wanted coming out of the break. 0 for 3 so far, and they're not playing with much intensity.
And Andre Iguodala with the slam.
He's still possessing that trademark athleticism. Whenever the veteran Iguodala throws it down, it energizes his teammates.
Red passes to 4. Outside, Kukoc. It up toward the rim, and that's out of bounds. Philadelphia will retain possession. Let's take another look at the staunch defense during that mobile one block.
And a block like that sends a message, one that says we're not giving up this lead. We talk about execution on the offensive end. They're leaving nothing on the table right now.
Absolutely relentless. Giannis. They're in the flow and riding that wave for as long as they can.
Trying to get something going, and he lays it up and in. Ford's got his second bucket of the game to go.
Finally, they get one to drop. That's one of their first four here in the third.
Dalembert, and it's blocked. That's out of bounds. The 76ers have a new take possession here. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Milwaukee trails by 14, and the pass to Red. Now the dish to Ford. It's hauled in by Allen Iverson. Iverson's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Driving in, and Iverson throws it down.
Taking matters into his own hands.
Yeah, we didn't expect to see that kind of finish.
No, but his teammates love that kind of energy, fellas. I mean, dunks like this demonstrate leadership.
Here's Booth. And even after two offensive rebounds, they just can't get the lid off. And Iverson gets it to go. 22 points for Iverson.
And it looks like they left their defensive effort back in the locker room, guys. They just haven't had the same commitment here defensively in the second half.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. For Milwaukee, they have gone 9-10 from the line, so making the most of their chances.
At the line for the Bucks.
First free throw is good. And so he hits both. And Greg, a lot of new head coaches stepping into this season. How does a first-year coach come in and win over a locker room?
I mean, Kevin, that's a great question. And I think there's a combination of confidence and humility that one has to have. And I think, believe it or not, the most important trait, you got to be consistent. Your message cannot waver. It cannot fluctuate. It's one way that you will lose a locker room.
Here's four. 76ers getting the bucket. Driving to the basket. Holly grabs the board. The 76ers leading by 18. And it's Salmons in the corner. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Holly, no good. It's tipped. It's stolen by Bradley. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
First team foul.
For Philadelphia, they have been a perfect 8-8 at the line.
At the line for two.
And he can't get the first one. Green is checked in for Andre Iguodala. And he's good on the second. And so James will bring it up for the Bucks. 19-point game. Drives to the hoop, and the dunk by James.
Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, G.A. He really does put pressure on
him. And guys, it's clear, though, he enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
Here's Hamilton. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the 76ers.
Their inside game has been great tonight. So much of their scoring has come from the paint.
And you've always heard of guys being in a zone shooting, but you can be in a zone passing the basketball. We've seen that tonight as well.
And the well is running dry for him right now. Nothing falling.
Yeah, he just hit a rough patch. He's trying to climb out of it, but hasn't been successful.
And it's James missing. The 76ers leading by 16. Here's Ollie. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
Second team foul.
It's his first trip to the line. Free throw good from Ollie.
Two shots.
Both free throws good from Ollie. James with it. Loose. And now the 76ers on the break. Here's Howling. Rebounded by the Bucks. James has got his fifth rebound in this one. Floats one. No good. Shot missing. Bradley with some nice D. And the 76ers with possession. They're on a 17-7 run. From deep, Green. Rebound, Milwaukee. James has got six rebounds here tonight. Pass to Strickland. Back to James. Passes to the eraser. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. Now the 76ers with it. They're on a 17-7 run. Out. Can't hit from in close. Milwaukee trails by 18. Driving the lane. Seven-foot shot. Selmans passes to Allen. Green kicks to Selmans. Pass to Strickland. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time.
Excellent work offensively to get that shot attempt into a can't-miss area.
Holly against James. Holly passes to Solomons. Here's Holly. Back to Solomons. Just five on the clock. Over James. And he dunks it down.
And just scrapes and claws for that offensive rebound and doesn't take any chances there with the put.
UGA, strong work all around. And the rebound and the stuff ball. Wow. Holly, no good.
Really surprising to see the huge edge they have in rebounds given what the scoreboard says.
James up top, covered by Barnes. Selmans grabs the miss. The 76ers leading by 18. Green passes to Allen. Back to Green. Here's Barnes. And play stops as it looks like they call it over the back here.
And guys, as soon as you start going over and through a rebounder, you're probably going to get whistled for over the back.
Little too aggressive. You appreciate the hustle. You want to be smart.
Brown is checked in for Philadelphia. And Milwaukee with a change here, too. Gill is checked in for Smith.
Straight rim rocker.
It looked like a great for a second, like he might rip the cylinder loose. It's Brown with the drive, banked in off the glass. Brown's got his first 2 points of the night.
And we always talk about making your teammate better. That assist was right on target.
Inside. Here's Hamilton. And another shot. And it's Bradley with the rebound. Bradley's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Barnes. And the dunk by Barnes.
Well, check out that assist. That's a pair of teammates that are clearly on the same page.
The drive by James. Some solid defense from Brown. Philadelphia leading by 20. A rebound by the Bucks. The Erasers got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Here's Strickland, and the Bucks miss again. Well, they're really making a point of keeping the ball moving around.
That's the key. The D can't focus on one player, and no matter what anybody tells you, that ball will always move quicker than the defense.
On the night, he's gone 2 for 2 with the strike. And the 76ers with some changes. Jackson is checked in for Brent. The machine comes in for Green, and Allen Iverson subbed in for Holly. Now here's Williams. 10 points for him. Here's the pass to Red to the inside. Here's Pachulia, and he converts the layup. Pachulia's got his first points in this one. Philadelphia shooting 40% from the field. The drive by Iverson, and the dunk by Iverson.
Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, G.A. He really does put pressure on.
Hey, guys, it's clear, though. He enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
Substitution for your 76.
Shot from the inbound. Dan Redd gets it to go on the assist by Pachulia.
Michael Redd.
Redd's got his second bucket of the night.
Now how about how he sets his man up there, runs it right into the screen, and then gets the basket.
He gets it in there.
Well, with the role he's on this quarter, they're going to keep going to him. Get that lead even bigger.
Gill against Korver. Shot on the wing. Gill misses. Philadelphia leading by 22. The drive by Iverson. And the dunk by Iverson.
He does all the little things. He does the big things. He's got them in front with another outstanding performance.
1:24 left of the third quarter. Here is Gantzarich. He's got 10. At six and stolen by Iverson. Goes up and Iverson throws it down.
Yeah, you can't afford to let Iverson come up with the steal there. An opportunistic defender who knows what to go for.
Here's Red and he slams it one-handed.
Just so fast. I mean, it's like trying to stop a train when he's coming in for the slam.
Iverson dishes to Jackson. And it goes down 2 points. Jackson's got 8 points.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
They get a hand on it. And he's going up for the alley-oop. An emphatic alley-oop jam.
Oh, such a beautiful pass to set that one.
Yeah, the pass might have been pretty, but the finish was angry. Against Williams. We've got 28 seconds left in the third. Here's Gantzarich. And Gantzak on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Clearly a foul.
Fourth team foul.
And he knocks down the first one.
Shooting.
Some changes for Philadelphia. Big Dog is checked in for Jackson. And it's Iguodala in for Brown. He's off on the second. Philadelphia shooting a hot 57% from the field in the third. Iverson, no luck. And it's Allen Iverson with the foul.
Allen Iverson.
That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two.
Shooting from Milwaukee. At the line for two.
And the first one at the line is good. Both free throws.
That's what they want to see from him, attacking, getting whistles, and maybe causing some foul trouble.
There's the drive. Can't connect from short range. Pass to Red. There's the three.
V, it'll make it to the steal stuff.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first three quarters. Key out there with the machine. And there's Iguodala. Then there's Big Dog. And it's Mashburn in at the four. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. We always have some tweaks to the rules every season, Chris. What do you think the league should focus on now when it comes to the next change?
You know, I would hope the league would address the boardroom. I hope they would address the ownership. I hope they would address management. Hopefully, the league can start to look like the makeup of the players that it employs when you talk about ownership and things of that nature.
Here's Korver, and goaltending is going to be the call. So they get the basket there anyway.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
And for Milwaukee, they're shooting 23% from the field. That's not going to get it done. Iguodala against Kukoc. It's right outside. Milwaukee the rebound, and the shot is good. So it's Philadelphia now. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
First team foul.
And the first one drops.
Your 76ers. Two shots.
All free throws good from Korver. And the Bucks with possession here. Pass to Gatsarich. A floater, and it's good on the way in.
Even from that range, the floater is one of the toughest shots in the game.
With the drive, McKee, no luck.
He hasn't chipped in with many points tonight. The good thing he has the guys around him to carry the weight.
Kicks
the
four. Pass to Red. Here's Gonzarich. A shot, no good. So Philadelphia will take it the other way. Here's McKee. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. You know, Chris, no one wants to see play stop for a coach's challenge. But is that inconvenience outweighed by ensuring it was the right call?
It definitely is, Kevin. You know, we'd rather get the calls right than just be putting quality over quickness. So that's how I like to think. But, you know, definitely, you don't want those calls all the time. But, yeah, late in the game, you need it. Guys work too hard.
And the Bucks making a change here. Smith has checked in. Knocked away. And now the 76ers on the break. It's Red outside. The basket good off the assist from Ford.
Or three.
Ford's got four assists now tonight.
And he's shaking off that slow start, giving them a boost here in the second.
Korver, good.
His energy level has never dropped in this game. I mean, he's working his tail off. And the D is struggling to keep up.
Outside, Kukoc. Smith trying to break loose. Kukoc can't get it to go. For Philadelphia, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter start. And now, here comes Red, leading the break. They grab their own miss. And wrestling for it there, but no one has possession. We'll have a jump ball. And the Bucks with possession here. Here's the floater. Smith, no good. They are in complete control.
This is the ultimate definition of the zone. Everything they've done has worked.
Such fluid moves. I mean, fast hands. Iguodala working over the defender.
I'm glad we got to see the Mobile One block once more. What a play.
And that has got to help the morale of this team. Let's see if that sets up a run here.
Kukoc passed to Red. 5 to shoot. And too much time to the way. They get called for the 3-second violation.
And just a little too lax with that possession. And it cost them.
Yeah, you got to be locked in at all times. Their inconsistent play is a big reason why they're losing.
Jackson, he's checked in for Philadelphia. Big Daddy comes in for Andre Iguodala.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic stuff.
Oh, yeah, bang, bang. Impressive sequence that has them fired up.
And a long windup and strong follow-through on the one-hand jam.
Yeah, he's not going to mess that one up. Here's Ford. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. And this August, the Summer League was back in Las Vegas, Greg. And that's where you're from. That's where you played. How pleased are you to see your hometown become a mecca for the game in the offseason?
Oh, it is such a proud moment for me, born and raised here, growing up here. And quite honestly, I'm just thrilled that we have Summer League again. After what we've gone through, partner, it is just a breath of fresh air to get back to focusing on the little things.
Pfizer. Rebounded by McKee. McKee's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Here's Green. Here's D'Alembert. A rebound by the Bucks. Here's the eraser. Out to the right wing. Bucks passing it around. Now Ford. for three. Smith, he puts it again.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's six o'clock.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. Some changes for Philadelphia. Bradley comes in for Big Dog. And Ollie subbed in for McKee. Here's Bradley. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
No question he got bumped on that shot.
At the line for your 76.
That free throw, no good.
Taking two shots.
So he comes up empty at the line. We're seeing a lot of top high school players opting for the G League over college now, Greg. What's your advice to top young players on their path to the NBA?
Well, Kevin, I think you just answered it. It's their path, and I don't think
shooting
the same path is right for everybody. There are going to be a lot of talented young men and women who want to go to college for the experience, you know, for the environment, for the networking, right? You're going to make some of the best friends you'll ever have on a college campus. Having said that, though, some kids aren't in the college, aren't in the school. They want to just go and pursue their passion and their craft, and that's why I think the G League and the developmental leagues that are out there are so good for these young players.
James, the pass to Strickland. Out to Kukoc. Busts the J after the KG pass fake. 76ers leading by 21. And here is Iverson. Kicks it out to Iguodala. A pass to Salmons. And here is Barnes, covered by Smith. Six to shoot. Here's Salmons. Here's D'Alembert. He gets that one to drop. He's now 5 of 12.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Here's Kukoc, and there's the drive. Misses in close. For Philadelphia, they've gone 5 of 11 from the field in the fourth quarter. Here's Barnes. That's good. Great play set up by Iverson. Iverson's got his 8th assist in the game. That's tipped. Iverson passes to Salmons. Kukoc with the steal. They're running. Here's James. Here's Booth. Second shot opportunity. Here's Smith. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot.
He's not going to back off when he's down. I mean, he's got a chance to attack the basket.
Iverson against James. Here's Salmons. Milwaukee with the rebound.
Even when the D is playing off of him, the mid-range jumper shouldn't be the shot they're looking for.
And it's Strickland missing. The 76ers leading by 23. And the dunk by Iverson.
And with the fast eyes, Iguodala finding the open man.
Iverson against James. And you look at the pathway to the NBA for young players, Chris, opportunities now to go pro at 16, 17 years of age. The landscape is certainly changing, isn't it?
Well, the NBA said they're going to take an active role, making sure these teams get the best coaching, training, learning, and overall, I see more promise.
And stolen by James. And here comes the break. Here's Strickland. Off with the layup. For Philadelphia, they've gone through the fourth quarter shooting 50%, 7 of 14. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Fourth team foul. At the line for your
He's off on the first. Michael Redd's checked in for the Bucks. Williams comes in for James. He hits the second from the line. And so it's Williams who brings it up for Milwaukee. Looking to get back on track here, and Philadelphia grabs the miss. Iverson's got his 6th rebound on the night. Loads it up for Iguodala. Hammers the alley-oop through.
And how about the communication between teammates on that alley-oop?
And that's what you need to pull that thing off. Williams dishes to Smith. Near the 3-point line, it's Red. Milwaukee, no good that time either. for Philadelphia. They've got a pretty good rhythm going offensively, shooting 8 of 15 for the quarter.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Starting to take over here, building a big lead that could ultimately prove insurmountable.
76ers foul. Aaron McKee.
Big group substitution here for Milwaukee. Pachulia is checked in. Hamilton comes in for Smith. The Erasers checked in for Kukoc. And it's Gill in for Michael Redd. Williams against McKee. Pass to Pachulia. Pulls up from the corner. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
Now, we see this all too often. You have to be willing to play.
And finish off by Brown.
Now, fellas, that was a vicious two-hand monster slam.
Guys, I don't think there was anyone who could have stopped him on that one. Here's Williams. Pachulia trying to break loose. Williams gets the bucket.
Look, that's a nice play. You need low post scoring to keep your offense balanced.
McKee, the pass to D'Alembert. Brown kicks to Selmans. Second chance shot. And the 76ers tack on two more.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Williams passes to Gill. Here's the Eraser. Outside Williams. Milwaukee keeping it alive. The new 14. 76ers shooting and hitting almost everything here in the fourth, up around 58% from the field. And it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here. And Philadelphia making a change here. Jackson's checked in. Here's McKee. It's tipped. And it goes out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
Last touch by Pachulia. Defense, the Bucks, and McKee kicks to Brown. No good from outside. Here's the Eraser. He's covered by Brown.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
Hamilton against Jackson. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
15 foul.
And back in the day, Greg, Allen Iverson got criticized for devaluing practice. Now, we've got healthy players sitting out of games. Has load management gone too far, you think?
Not a practice, but a game. We got guys missing games, Kevin. There's no doubt about it. But I'm really all for load management in this regard. If I owned a team and I had to invest $200 million in a player, I want to do everything I can to prolong my investment. And the reality is we've got our stars playing at unprecedented lifts at higher levels later in their career. So I'm all for doing what we can to prolong the careers of our very best players.
Williams against Allen. Williams with the defensive effort. And for Milwaukee, they're shooting around 37% in the fourth quarter. The minutes starting to wear on them.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. You can safely say mission accomplished now for the 76ers.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought. An all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that. And man, they just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And with this effort tonight, grabbing their eighth win of the year.
And this is a great way for them to kick off this season series. Two more games ahead, and they've taken the mental advantage with this win tonight. And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was
for Iverson.
Oh, man, anticipation, instincts, energy, all his tools were on display tonight as he lit the place up.
Here's Fizer. The shot, no good. And it's Philadelphia the other way. Brown drives in. That shot off the mark. There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock. Williams to the middle. Here's Pachulia. That's short off the rim. Brown outside. He kicks it to Selmans. Can't nail the jump.
And if you ask me what percentage of the time he's making that shot, my answer would be in the single digits.
Yeah, that's not his spot, plain and simple. He's trying to force something that's rarely a good idea.